So, we will start the reaction of haloarenes. We already completed the reactions of haloalkanes. In that, we completed SN1 reaction, SN2 reaction, elimination reaction, and then reaction with metals. Okay, today we are going to start with reaction of haloarenes. In reaction of haloarenes, first we are going to study about reaction of metals. Reaction of metals. So this is one haloarene. So halogen plus arene ring. Haloarene. So I am taking two haloarenes and I am going to react it with two sodium in the presence of dry ether. In the presence of dry ether. How many sodium are there? Two. So two sodiums I will be writing like this. How many haloarenes are there? Two. So the two haloarenes I am writing like this. Okay, so this sodium and this X will combine together. This sodium and this X will combine together. It will form NaX. This will also form NaX. So I will get how many NaX? 2 NaX I will get. This benzene ring and this benzene ring, it will form a compound like this. One benzene ring will get attached to another benzene ring like this. Okay, so this is called as diphenyl. Diphenyl. X means it can be any halogen. Chlorine, bromine, iodine, it can be any halogen. Okay, so NaClr, Cla, NaBr, Na(I), anything it can be. Okay, so understood? This reaction, it is called as Wittig reaction. So what is the name of this reaction? Wittig reaction. Okay. Now instead of haloarene, if I take haloalkane, haloalkane means benzene ring will not be there. What will be there? Alkyl group will be there. RX. Same way I am going to react it with sodium in the presence of dry ether. I am going to react in the presence of dry ether. So how many X is there? 2X is there. So 2X and 2 sodium, it will form 2NaX. So how many R is there? 2R groups. So those 2R groups will form RR. Okay. So in the reactant molecule, only one, this molecule is having only one R, but in the product, it will become double. For example, if I take CH3X plus 2Na, if I take, what will be my product? Tell me. This 2Na and this 2X, it will form 2NaX. This CH3 will combine with another CH3 and it will form CH3 single bond CH3. CH3 means what? Methyl group. Yes or no? But in the product, what I am getting? Ethane I am getting. Okay. So one carbon compound is changing into two carbon compound. So if I take a two carbon compound, it will change into four carbon compound. So the number of carbon will become double. Okay. So the number of carbon atoms will become double in the product. Will become double in the product. Okay. So if you do this reaction with haloarene, it is called Wittig reaction. If you do this reaction with haloalkane, it is called Wood's reaction. It is called as Wood's reaction. So what will be Wood's-Wittig reaction? Wood's-Wittig reaction. What will be my Wood's-Wittig reaction? Woods Fittig reaction means, Woods means what? Haloalkane. Fittig means what? Haloarene. Two haloarenes means it is Fittig. Two haloalkanes means it's wood. So Woods Fittig means one haloalkane and one haloarene. Okay, one haloalkane and one haloarene. If it combines with the two sodium in the presence of dry ether, what I will get? This two sodium will combine with this X and this X. And it will form what? 2NaX. Remaining what all will combine together? This benzene ring and this R group will combine together. And I will get benzene ring with R group. Okay, so this is called as Fittig reaction, Woods reaction and Woods-Fittig reaction. So understood the reaction of metals. So this is my first chemical property in haloarenes. The next one is electrophilic substitution reaction. Electrophilic substitution reaction. So the next one is electrophilic substitution reaction. Electrophilic substitution reaction. So what is electrophile? Already I have told you what is electrophile. Electrophile means positively charged species. What is electrophile? Positively charged species. So when a species will get positive charge, if it is not having enough electrons, okay, it will get a positive charge. So electrophile we can also call them as electron deficient species. They do not have sufficient electrons. They are electron deficient. So they are called as positively charged species. Understood? So electrophile is going to come and get substituted. So, in a haloarene, the electrophilic substitution, the electrophile, it gets substituted only in ortho and para position. An electrophile gets substituted only in ortho and para positions. Okay. They get substituted only in ortho and para position. So ortho and para position means what? In benzene ring, I told you there are three positions. This position is ortho position. This position is meta position. This position is para position. So in which position the electrophile will come and get attached? It will get attached only in ortho position and para position. Why it will get attached only in ortho and para position, that we are going to write now. Okay, I am going to explain. Suppose, I will explain it this side. I am taking one haloarene. So this is my haloarene. So X means what? X means halogen. Halogens, how many electrons will be there in the last shell? For example, chlorine is a halogen. Atomic number 17, it will be arranged as 287. Yes or no? So, how many electrons are there in the last shell? 7. So, in that 7 electron, 1 electron is involved in the bonding. So, remaining how many electrons will be there in the outer side? 6 electrons will be there in the outer side. Okay. Now, in this 6 electrons, okay, this 2 electrons will come down to form a bond. If these 2 electrons comes down to form a bond, this bond will come outside and it will form as a minus charge here. So how I will get is, I will get like this. So already one bond is there for X. Now two more electrons have come down, so it will form a double bond here. Okay, so the remaining two pairs, it will be like this. Now what happened to this bond? It has come outside and it is like a minus charge. Now this minus charge, if it becomes a bond here, this will come down and it will become a minus charge here. So what I will get now? So this one has come here. So this side I will get the bond. This bond has come down as a minus charge. So here I have double bond X. Okay. Now if this bond comes here, what will happen? This bond will go up this side. Okay. Now what I will get? This bond, it has come here. So here I will get the bond. This bond has gone as a minus charge here. Okay. So double bond X, it will be like this. Now if this bond comes here, okay, again this bond will go up like this. Okay, again this bond will go up like this. So what I will be getting? So I will be getting a structure like this. Again this bond will go up and it will be as two electrons. Okay, so I will be getting a structure like this. So these structures are called as resonance structures. What are these structures called as? Resonance structures. Now if I see the resonance structure, in which position and all I am getting the negative charge? Here I am getting the negative charge in the ortho position. Here I am getting the negative charge in the para position. Here the position which is opposite to ortho, that is also ortho position only. So here I am getting the position in the ortho position. So only in the ortho and para position I am getting the negative charge. What is the charge of the electrophile? Positive charge. So positive will be attracted by the negative charge. Negative charge I am getting only in the ortho and para position. So the positive charge electrophile will get attached only in the ortho and para position. So the resonance structures, in the resonance structures I am getting the negative charge. The negative charge is seen only in ortho and para positions. Ortho and para positions. So the electrophile will get substituted only in ortho and para position. Gets substituted only in ortho and para positions. So understood why electrophilic substitution occurs only in ortho-para position. If they ask, you should draw this electron dot structure and you should write this form. Okay. So in electrophilic substitution, the first one is halogenation. The first electrophilic substitution is halogenation. So I am taking one haloarene Cl. In this I am going to add another halogen Cl2. This I am going to do in the presence of anhydrous ferric chloride. Anhydrous ferric chloride. So this chlorine, how it will get separated? This chlorine will get separated as Cl and Cl. Yes or no? So, one Cl will become the electrophile. Okay. So, it will get attached in which all positions? In ortho position it can get attached and in para position it can get attached. So, I can get two types of products. So, one product, the chlorine will be attached in ortho position and in another product, the chlorine will be attached in the para position. Understood? I can get two types of products. So which will be my major product and which will be my minor product? Tell me. Both the chlorines are halogens. Yes or no? So here if they are nearby, there will be repulsion. Okay, if they are nearby, what will be happening? There will be repulsion. So this will be a minor product. Because of repulsion, this product will be less stable. Okay, so this will be my minor product. Here they are placed very far away. Yes or no? So they will be stable. So this product will be my major product. So why this product is minor product? Because this is less stable. Unstable in Edithanda, you can write it as less stable. This product, why it is major product? Because it is more stable. Understood? Why it is less stable? Because both the halogens are nearby, so repulsion will be there. Here both the halogens are placed far away, so there will be less repulsion. So it is a stable major product. Understood? Halogenation. This is my first electrophilic substitution reaction. Now my second electrophilic substitution is nitration. Nitration means adding of nitro group. Nitration means what? Adding of nitro group. Nitro group means NO2 group. Nitro group means what? NO2 group. So to get this nitro group, you must add a nitrating agent. So to get the nitro group, you must add a nitrating agent. So what is my nitrating agent? Concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid. Together, they are called as the nitrating agent. So what is nitrating agent? Concentrated nitric acid and concentrated sulfuric acid, they are called as nitrating agents. So to a haloarene, I am going to add a nitrating agent. So this is my haloarene. To this, I am going to add this nitrating agent. So, when I add nitrating agent, what group I will get? I will get the nitro group. So, the nitro group, in which all position it will get attached? It will get attached in the ortho position and para position. Okay? So, it will get attached in the ortho position or it will get attached in the para position. So which will be my major product and which will be my minor product? Tell me. Here two groups are together. So repulsion will be there. So this product will be my minor product. Here two groups are placed far away. So there will be less repulsion. So it will be my major product. Okay. So the third electrophilic substitution is sulfonation. So the third electrophilic substitution is sulfonation. Okay. So sulfonation means I am going to add sulfonate group. Okay. What group I am going to add? Sulfonate group. So what is this sulfonate group? SO3H group. This group is called as the sulfonate group. So how I will get this sulfonate group? This sulfonate group, it is obtained from concentrated sulfuric acid. It is obtained from concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay. So I am taking a haloarene. Okay. So to this haloarene, I am going to add concentrated sulfuric acid and I am going to heat it. So when I add concentrated sulfuric acid and if I heat it, what will happen? I will get this sulfonate group. So where all the sulfonate group will get attached? In the ortho position and in the para position. So what are the products I will get, right? So one product in the ortho position plus another product in the para position. SO3H. So which will be my major product and which will be my minor product? This will be my minor product because both the groups are together, repulsion will be there. And this will be my major product because both the groups are far away, so there will be less repulsion. Understood? So the fourth one is Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Friedel Crafts alkylation is a very very important 3-mark question. Alkylation, because it is a name reaction, it is a very very important 3-mark question. Okay, so I am going to take a halo arene. To this I am going to add a alkyl halide, CH3Cl. This is one alkyl halide. So alkyl halide I am going to add. So to a haloarene, if I add a alkyl halide, it is called as Friedel Crafts alkylation. Okay. So the reagent which is used here is anhydrous aluminium chloride. Anhydrous aluminium chloride. See in the exam, if you see this anhydrous aluminium chloride, then you can blindly you can write that it is Friedel Crafts alkylation. Friedel Crafts alkylation alone will have this reagent. Okay, so whenever you see this anhydrous aluminium chloride, you can conclude that it is what reaction? Friedel Crafts alkylation. Understood? So what is Friedel Crafts alkylation? It is the reaction between haloarene and alkyl halide. So this CH3 is my alkyl group. Yes or no? This alkyl group will get attached in the ortho position and para position. So what are the products I will get? First, with the ortho position, and what will be my another product? In the para position. Okay. So which will be my major product, this will be my minor product and this will be my major product. So understood what is Friedel Crafts alkylation? Yes. So the last electrophilic substitution is Friedel Crafts acylation. Friedel Crafts acylation. Friedel Crafts alkylation or Friedel Crafts acylation, any one they will ask in 3-mark question. Understood? So Friedel Crafts alkylation means haloarene is reacting with alkyl halide. Okay, Friedel Crafts acylation means haloarene will react with what? Acyl halide. Okay. So what is this acyl halide? So first I am going to write this haloarene. So haloarene means I am going to write one haloarene plus acyl halide. Alkyl halide means what? CH3Cl. Acyl halide means, make a note, CH3C double bond OCl. What is acyl halide? CH3C double bond OCl. CH3C double bond O. This group is called as the acyl group. For Friedel Crafts reaction, always the reagent is anhydrous aluminium chloride. So whenever you see anhydrous aluminium chloride, you can conclude that it is Friedel Crafts reaction. So here also it will be anhydrous aluminium chloride. So this acyl group COCH3, this group will be attached in ortho position and para position. Okay. So if it is in the ortho position, what I will get? Cl C double bond O CH3. So this is my ortho product. But ortho product will be my minor product. So what will be my major product? C double bond O CH3. So this will be my major product. So understood? Yes. So these are the 5 electrophilic substitution reactions. So today we started the chemical properties of haloarenes. In that we studied 2 reactions. First one is reaction with metals. In that what all we studied? Woods reaction, Wittig reaction, Woods-Wittig reaction. Next, electrophilic substitution. First, we studied why it occurs in ortho and para position. Next we studied the five things. One is halogenation, nitration, sulfonation, Friedel Crafts alkylation and Friedel Crafts acylation. So the remaining things we will continue in the next class. Thank you.